Terence Crawford has posted the following to Jamal Charlo, the king of the 160 division. He tells him, you coming down to fight me at 154, bro, I know you would. I believe you too, but your brother is still a wuss. Terence Crawford, there's a lot of talk of him fighting Errol Spence. He wants to fight Spence. He says he wants to fight Charlo, and now he's open to fight Jamal Charlo. One thing I will say about the Charlo twins, one thing for sure, they're not wusses. They have never turned down a fight. They'll fight anyone, anywhere, anytime. And they've proven it. Both have been champs. Jamal 32-0. Jamal is the king of the 154 division, undisputed, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters on the planet. No ifs, ands, or buts. Anybody that doesn't have Jamal Charlo on your pound-for-pound list is toilet paper. You could rip it up. You could throw it down the toilet. It's trash. Here's an interview I did a while back with Jamal. We talk about Crawford, Joe Smith, Bitterbayev, and much more. Check it out. What do you think about your brother and Crawford? Crawford says he wants to fight him.
Crawford don't want to fight him. I talked to Crawford myself. I don't believe everything that's on the media. Some people even say shit on the media and don't even mean that shit. You know what I'm saying?
What happens when he fights Earl?
Like that's unexpected, bro. We don't know. Like, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Crawford is a strong fighter. I like his style. He switches back and forth and stuff. Earl real technical. So you got two different, you know what I'm saying? That's not a discovery, so we don't know. Hopefully he come up 54 and challenge my brother.
How long do you think you stay at 60?
Me?
Yeah.
I can make it 60. I can make it 60.
Not a problem.
I'm making it pretty good now.
Like, yeah?
Got nutrition.
You used to be at 54.
Yeah, I'm light hitting right now. Shit, it's how you change a regimen. Our regimen is real strong.
You come watch him every day?
I come and watch him. I'm just getting out. I train earlier than him today, so I got a chance to come over. I'm like in my second workout already, so I'm like, let me stop by.
How did you guys come up with Lions Only? What was the source of that?
It was crazy because we was watching the Discovery Channel. We always considered ourselves, you know, lions in boxing. And we was watching the Discovery Channel and I guess we had it on, like, the lion was like attacking an elephant and he was like bringing him down. He grabbed him by the trunk, he was making him holler. I was like all into it, like, yo, my brother was like, cut that off, man. Like, I want to see that type of shit. I'm like, bro, this is us, though. We gotta eat. They don't mean no harm. It's nature, bro. We gotta go eat. You gotta survive. Then they showed the weary lion where he wasn't really attacking the elephants and he was about to die.
Yep.
And I said, that ain't how we want to be, so we gotta go eat. And that's how we just came up with it.
And like, it's tough.
Yeah.
And you've been like that from day one, pretty much.
Yeah, like, real. Like, and right after that, one guy, like, got it tatted. I knew I was lying. Legacy is our legacy now. So
he's in killer mode.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, Bitterbayev or Joe Smith?
Yeah, I like Joe Smith. You know, I like how he, I like where he came from. I like Joe Smith. So I'll probably take him just to be in bias, just because I like him.
Is you and Boo Boo an option?
It maybe so. I'm at 60, man. I'm a king of 60, so I'm finna wear my crown at 60.
I would love to see you in Triple G.
I know that would be a good fight too. You know,
he might fight Canelo again. What happens in the third one?
They got bad blood, so like, you know what I'm saying. I'm here for that too. I'm not no fighter. Like, everybody, y'all make y'all money. Y'all do y'all thing. Like,
everybody has to eat. Yep, you're right.
Forever,
that's the thing. You can't wait. You just gotta keep moving.
Go get it, but shit. They want it, they want it. They don't. So you know what I'm saying? Like, just gotta fight who they give you. I never told Al Haney no to nobody.
No,
I never made a contract before. And
I want to tell fans, you've never turned down a fight.
Nah, I never.
But I want to make it clear, because people always, you know, someone starts a false thing and everybody runs with it. You will fight Godzilla, King Kong, anywhere, anytime. They tell you, sign the thing, let's do it.
Yeah, you already know.
And your brother's the same way.
Kill us, bro. My mom made razor. We gonna fight, bro. We fought each other, goddammit. We will still fight each other.
So, growing up, who's your favorite fighter?
Man, I was a big Diego Corrales fan. Growing up in the amateurs, I was a big fan of... Man, it's the list.
Looking great, by the way.
Yeah. I've been a good, been into it, so, you know.
How many you got?
So many good fighters out there. Diego Corrales was one of my top dogs.
He was great. Rest in peace.
Yeah. Brandon Forrest was one of the
Another one. Rest in peace, too.
We looked, up to.
He was a great fighter.
Yeah.
Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.